We continue to celebrate the remarkable career of Linda Yu. Another surprise for Linda. Look at this. It's a specially made 330-pound cheesecake from Eli's. But you have to eat it all show ends at 5 o'clock.
Is Shanghai. No other city can capture the urgency and the excitement of China's economic reform than Shanghai, a port city on the Huangpu River just behind me. Shanghai has a population of more than 17 million people and is now a powerhouse of ambition. It's one of the world's most crowded urban areas. Malls popping up at every corner, a dynamic surge of wealth with a new hip urban lifestyle and pulsating nightlife. Shanghai's master plan is on public display at an exhibition hall. It includes projects by the Chicago firm that will house Chinese firms and companies from around the world that have rushed to make their mark on the city.
So that was 10 years ago.
It's hard to believe.
When Linda traveled to China to report on how Chicago's business relationships in China were vital to the city. Does it seem
amazing?
That long ago?
No, it doesn't, but it seems amazing because it was so modern already, you know. But that trip also was very personal.
Yeah, while reporting in China, Linda returned to her birthplace, Xi'an. Am I saying that right? How do you say it?
Xi'an.
To find out, even though there were many physical changes, she was still remembered.
Where I was born. We've come back to see how my home city has changed. 900 miles from the coast, you could say it's the Midwest of China. Most Americans know the city as the location of the famous terracotta warriors. Xi'an was once the capital city for 13 dynasties. A friend who lives elsewhere in Xi'an helped in my search. She discovered that 5 blocks away lived the woman, Mrs. Li, who once remembered when I was born in Xi'an and remembered my visit more than 20 years ago. She's in her 80s now, very frail. I didn't expect her emotion, but she said it meant so much that I would return. She still remembered my Chinese name, Xiaoling, and my mother. In fact, she had saved the pictures I once sent. Her copy of one picture is weathered. It had been displayed for years. My copy was intact. I had kept it in a file. Other pictures have faded over the years. Mr. Li has Alzheimer's now and last year a stroke, but he was brought out of the hospital to come honor me. It was my honor to see him. A grown daughter remembered that she was 18 years old when I came before. Now she has children of her own. Mrs. Lee's grandchildren and great-grandson came too. Mrs. Li began to reminisce and tell me stories of my family. Your grandmother used to buy those big peaches. She called my mother to come over so we could share. When my mother cooked something good to eat, she called your grandmother to come over. The visit was tiring for Mrs. Li and too short. Though she and Mr. Li had trouble walking, they insisted, "Wasungni." It was only proper and polite that they see me out. I was afraid the emotion might be too much for them. The thought came to my mind even as it came to theirs. This would be the last time we would meet. They are both frail, and I would not come back before both their lives are over. Many years ago, I promised to come back to see them again. This time, I am grateful that I kept that promise.
It's 10 years ago.
10 years ago already, it's hard to believe.
Do you have memories of living in China before you came here?
It's interesting that I do. From the first couple of years of my life, I actually had two images. Mm-hmm. And I think one of them was because I saw it every single day. I was born in a room, that dirt floors, little building, you know, dirt floors. And I used to look out the window every day. My mother said from lying on her bed. And I just saw a ray of sunshine coming in, and it looked like a little person, and it was my sister sitting there playing with her pet rabbit. That's what I remember seeing.
Wow, that's incredible. We're not done with your farewells, okay. By the way, okay?
Linda, you have been an icon, an inspiration to millions, a trusted voice during times of uncertainty, and a role model to countless young women, a fierce advocate for Asian Americans, and most of all, a friend. You may be leaving the airwaves, but you will never leave our hearts. Good luck and happy retirement.
Break! Look! Pull! Punch!
It's your
team. Oh! fantastic. You wish you could fall for longer. And then all of a sudden, the chute opens up, and it really does. It gets absolutely quiet, and the first thing you go is...
Didn't that hurt? That was you.
It was great.
It was? It was
great. Yeah, bit my lip, though, and you said it was all bloody.
You could see a little bit, yes.
Pretty bloody. Right?
So all day, Lynn has been saying her goodbyes to everyone here at ABC 7 and to you at home. Today, she was the star guest on Windy City Live.
So nice.
There were lots of laughs and tears and cheers.
You're not just my mom. Everybody loves you. Oh, the whole city of Chicago.
Gotta make you a proud son.
Yeah. Was it hard for you to share your mom with all of these strangers that you didn't know as growing up as a kid?
No, because, you know, all these people love her, and why would I want to deny anybody that?
Aww.
Many of them are still here.
I know, it was lovely too. Thanks to everyone.
Linda, there's a panda story. Oh. We learned the names of these two cute twin pandas born earlier this year.
One more panda story.
Yes.
Good luck, Linda, on your retirement. We love you.
Well, happy retirement to you, Linda. We hope that the best times of your life are ahead of you.
Thanks for everything you've done for the city of Chicago. We'll miss you.
I just want to thank you for your years on Channel 7. And you are a lovely lady.
I can't believe that you're leaving.
Hi, Linda. It's Lisa Ling. So a lot has changed since you came to our wedding 9 years ago. Say hi, Jet.
Hi.
And this is Ray. Say hi, Ray. We're on a road trip heading to my sister's house in the Bay Area, but we just wanted to wish you the happiest retirement. You have always been such an inspiration to me, and I can't wait to play more. So come visit us in L.A. We love you, and congratulations.
How does she do it? How do you stay so young? What's next for Linda after she leaves the anchor desk? It's coming up. Also, a rainy day. Meteorologist Cheryl Scott updates her Thanksgiving Day forecast.
The entire thing started because of a long-term debate over whether or not that car should be parked in the driveway.
Those gangs in Hong Kong number actually in the thousands.
The race for governor, California voters have been changing their minds very rapidly since the June primary.
A look at Linda throughout her remarkable career, the many hairstyles that have kept her young and in vogue. You've been doing this a while.
Been doing it for a long time.
You know, accounting for vacations over her years at ABC 7, we figure that Linda has opened the 4 o'clock newscast with her hello more than 7,700 times.
And I remember every single one.
You do. What's next for Linda? Here's ABC 7's Paul Meincke.
Rob, on Sunday night, we revealed some things about Linda that you may not have known. I purposely held one of those things for today, and you can guess. The age of a lady can be a sensitive issue. It is not so with Linda. She loves it when people guess how old she is, and she smiles because they usually get it wrong.
To the street we go with a picture of you and a question.
How old do you think she is?
Early 50s, maybe?
That picture, she looks about 40.
Maybe 50, 51.
Oh, she loves you too.
All right, time for truth, dear. How old are you?
The official last day of my contract is my 70th birthday.
There you go. Seldom has the big 70 looked so good. Over the years, the hair has changed, but not the face. How can it be?
I don't know, probably moisturizing.
She got the genes. I can't explain it other than that.
She's just a joy to be around. I mean, she's an attractive woman who seems to be unaware of that.
She lets us do what we want to do.
No special beauty regimen, but Linda does have something of a theory.
I think some of it is attitude. Some of it is working hard and keeping yourself going all the time. You know, I think that's part of it. It's like I haven't relaxed enough to let my face sag.
But now comes a new day without news deadlines. Life's clock is the only one that matters. Time for the most important, family, loved ones, and causes that will always remain near and dear.
I can't believe that Linda will sit on her hands. Not possible.
Linda is a go-getter and very driven, so maybe she's not sitting at a news desk every day, but she'll definitely be doing something else, I have no doubt.
What I'm really looking forward to is taking the first winter and taking some time just to think about, what do I want to do?
And while she contemplates that question, she can proudly look back at the little girl who came from China knowing just three words of English, who became the young lady with an incomparable work ethic, who has always shared her good fortune while mastering her profession and inspiring others to follow her lead.
There are women of every color who've come up to me and said, I watch you, you're my hero, you're my role model. That's so important to me to feel like, you know, I've done some good.
It's said that beauty comes from a life well lived. Linda will now live a life without the deadline she has known for over 45 years, but she will most certainly not relax because doing so might allow her face a chance to sag. Hey, you're sagging, dear. Come on.
All right, be careful, right? Keep the face.
Keep them up. Keep them up.
Thank you so much. Paul has done such wonderful, wonderful reports.
It's been my joy.
Best writer. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You tossed to weather.
Oh, I tossed to weather one last time.
No,
no, Cheryl. I'll miss you too, Cheryl.
Mother Nature's okay. Crying outside. I don't know if I'm going to get through this without crying. All so bittersweet.
We love you.
Love you too. Love
most
you guys.
Importantly.
All right. And listen up. Watch this because I get to do one last panda story here on TV. Today, the Vienna Zoo revealed the names of the twin baby pandas who were born in August. The male will be called Fu Ban, meaning lucky companion. The female named Fu Feng, or Lucky Phoenix. The official nameplates were unveiled by the Austrian Vice Chancellor and the Chinese Ambassador to Austria. I'm going to pause so we can just look at the cuteness. Pause, pause. The pandas are the fourth and fifth cubs born to Mother Yang Yang after Fu Long, Fu Hu, and Fu Bao.
Very nice.
So now to the man who's been here on this set with you more than any of us, Jim Rose, has your sports. Yeah.
And after a day off, the Blackhawks hope to erase the bad taste of Monday's beatdown at sports.
Appreciate it. Eli's has baked up one of their finest treats, chocolate strawberry cake. It weighs more than 300 pounds.
Wow.
We'll miss you. We love you. Linda's final thoughts next.
Oh, good luck, and I know you'll be extremely happy, but we'll miss you. Bye-bye.
We love you.
We love you.
We love you.
Now retiring after a long and distinguished career, number seven, Linda Yu. Hi, I'm Gene Honda, public address announcer for the White Sox and the Blackhawks. And Linda, thank you for everything you've done for the Asian American community here in Chicago. I hope you'll still wave when you come to the ballpark.
Definitely. Thank you, Gene Honda. And now, it's time. So, on board the ship that brought me to the United States so many years ago, my mother taught me three words of English. Thank you and hello. I have been blessed beyond my comprehension to have had more than 33 years with all of you, 37 years actually, on Chicago TV. And this long career would not have been possible without you, who watched, who wrote, who called, who posted, who supported me, and I am so grateful. But right now, I want to talk to you about those who will still be here after I leave. This is a changing world, and you will have no better team of people to help you learn about it, understand it, and navigate it than the reporters, the camera people, the technicians, everyone, and the newsroom management here at ABC7. And I'll be joining you in being part of that audience that depends on them every single day. And now, as I leave the news at 4 and ABC7, I go back to my first three words of English. Thank you to the dedicated, wonderful people here. Thank you to you, our loyal audience. My mother didn't teach me the words goodbye, so promise me that when you see me on the streets of Chicago, you will say hello.
Outstanding.
We'll miss you.